Hi. Today in this class we will be studying network analysis and we will be calculating these few things. The first thing over here is earliest starting time and earliest finishing time. Then we have the latest start time and latest finish time for every activity. And also we have to calculate tail slack and head slack respectively. Before we move further, we have to construct a network diagram and we have to calculate the critical path. And we have to calculate what is the project completion time. So we will start with the question. Over here we are given, we have activity, the preceding activities, the time that will be required for these activities. Before we start calculating the ESCAC, for most important thing is to draw a network diagram. So we will be starting, we will start with drawing the network diagram. Okay, let's start. Okay, as you all can see, the first activity, which is A, doesn't have any preceding activity. That means we have to start an activity, we will draw a big circle. Then, okay, we will be naming this activity as 1, where, right, and the name of the activity is A, and it requires around 6 days to complete. Right, it requires around 6 days to complete, and the ending node we number it as 2. We number the ending node as 2. Okay, as you all can see, the next activity that we have is activity B, and activity C. Both the activities have a common preceding activity. That activity is activity A. So what we will do is, we will construct both the activities from activity A like this. A big circle. And down. A circle. We will name these. Right? Before that we will name the activity B, activity C. Activity B requires 7 days to complete. Activity C requires 9 days to complete. Activity B requires 7 days to complete. Activity C requires 9 days to complete. Right? So we will number it as 3 and 4. Right? Okay. As we move further, you can see there is an activity. Activity D, which starts from activity B, and activity E has a preceding activity, activity C, right? And both the activities D and E are the preceding activities for F. Both the activities are the preceding activities of F. That means both these activities should have an ending node that should be common. So what we will do, we will make a merge kind of an event, right, which starts from activity B, the ending node of activity B. We will construct, right, a circle. Okay. And from activity C, the ending node, we will construct another activity, right? Okay. The activity which is the preceding activity, which has the preceding activity B? B has the preceding activity. And it has around 12 days, it needs 12 days to complete. Similarly, activity E over here has around 7 days. And it requires 7 days to complete and it has a preceding activity C, right? Why we have made a merge event? The reason is both the activities, D and E, are the preceding activity or the next activity, which is known as the activity F. Right? That means the activity F has a single starting node, which is the end node of activity D and activity E. Right? So we will number it as 5. And the last activity that we have is activity F, which has the ending node here at 6. Right. Okay, we will name it. The name of the activity is F, and it requires around 8 days to complete. Just have a look. Okay, let's see what is the path in the network. Before that, we will just make two hubs in every node that we have. Right? Okay, let's start numbering. Over here we will write 0 because this activity doesn't have any preceding activity. Then 0 plus 6 will give you 6. Right? 6 plus 7 will give you 13. 13 plus 12 will give you 25. 25 and 8 will give you 32. So we are having around 33 days when we go by the path ABDF, right? The name of the path is ABD and F. We require around 33 days. Okay, let's move on to the next path that we have. Okay. This is saying 0 plus 6 will give you 6, 6 and 9 will give you 15, 15 and 7 will give you around 22, right? But we have, we have 22 over here, but we have to take the bigger value, which is 25. Here we have 25, here we have 22, so we have to take the bigger value, that is 25. And 25 and 8 again is 33. Okay, now we will go backwards. 33 minus 8. 33 minus 8 will give you 25. 25 minus 12 will give you 13. 13 minus 7 will give you 6. And 6 minus 6 will give you 2. Right? Okay. Then, over here, 33 minus 8, 25. 25 minus 7 will not give you 15, it will give you 18. No problem. Okay? We have 18 over here. As we go by path A, C, E and F, how many days do we require? Is 9 and 6 is 15, 15 and 7 is 22, 22 and 8 is 30 days. Right? That is the reason we are getting 3 days less. Or 3 days more in this ticket. Okay. All of you know, we have to take the path which has maximum number of days. So, our critical path will be A, B, D and F. Our critical path will be A, B, D and F. So, we will be drawing a double arrow
representing our critical path. Representing our critical path. Right. This is our critical path. Okay. The next thing that we will be doing is calculating the earliest start time, earliest finish time, then the latest start time and latest finish time. For that, we have to construct a table. As you all know, we have a formula to calculate the earliest start time. Or what you can do is fill up all the values which you are getting in the first column of the lower column and the left hand side. Right. Before that, we will be just putting in the values required for the activities: 6 days for A, 7 days for B, 9 days for C, 12 days for D. Then we have 7 for E and 8 for F. Right? Okay. Early start time. What we will be doing is the lower left hand side the value we will be putting in 0, 6, 13, 25, and 32. 0, 6. 13, then we have 25, sorry, 0, 6, 13, 25, okay, yes, we haven't taken one value, which is the value of this node, the value is 15. So we will write down 15. Then we will move on to 25. And we will move on to the F activity, which is 30. Okay. By mistake, we haven't taken the value of the E activity. And then we have 25.
Okay.
066, 1359, 25. Right? As you can see, 0, we earlier starting point, then we have 6, then we have 13, then we have 15, then we have 25.
Okay.
We are not taking this because this is the ending node, we can call only the starting node.
Okay.
Okay. Then we move ahead to calculate EFP. I'll just put in the formula for EFP. It is really simple. Your earliest start time plus your time required to complete the activity.
Okay?
The earliest start time and the time required to complete the activity. What we have to do is just add up these two values. Right? 6 plus 0 will give you 6. 7 plus 6 will give you 13. 9 and 6 will give you 15. 35 will give you 25. This will give you 19. And the last value will give you 30. The last value will give you 30. This is 20, right? Okay. Okay. Then, before we calculate the latest start time, first we will be calculating the latest finish time. What we have to do is, as we have seen in the earliest start time, the left hand side of the lower column, we will be seeing the right hand side of the ending node 1, right? We will be seeing the right hand side of the ending node. Okay, over here, activity A ke andar, we have the ending node. This is the ending node. On the right hand side, we have the value 6. So we will put down 6, right? Okay, then we move on to activity B. Activity B ke andar, this is the ending node, and on the right hand side, we have the value 13. Okay, let's see, the F activity ka ending node is this, and the value we will be getting is 13. Right, okay. Let's see what is the LST then. Simple, it is. As we added any value in the earlier start time, now what we will do is, we will minus it from the total duration, right? For example, 6 minus 6 is 0. Okay, yes. LST will be again and time will be start. Okay, here we have LST minus the time. Okay. 13 minus 7, 6. 15 minus 9, 6. 25 minus 12, 13. 22 minus 7, 15. Yeah. And 33 minus 8 is 22. So this is how we calculate the different values of start time. The different values of start time. Earlier start time, latest start time, and the finish time, the earliest finish time and the latest finish time for each and every activity. Right? Okay. Now, okay, just have a look till here. See that if there is any problem, let me know. Okay, now how do we calculate slack of tail and slack of head? Right? Okay. As you all know, LI stands for your tail. Right, and J will be your head event. Okay, the formula is L I minus I P I over here L J minus P J. Let's see. Over here we will get 0. Okay, just a minute. We will be out here. We are solving K. So this is K. So this is 0. Over here this is the tail. Again we will have 0. Then over here this is the tail. That is 18 minus 15 will give you 3. Over here again a 0. For activity D and 0 for activity E also. For activity A also it is 0. So we have 0, 0, 3. 0, 0. Okay. Just a minute. We did something. Okay. Before I want to solve the sack of tail and head, let us draw a diagram representing the activity and the two roles. Right? This is your activity, for example, A, right? And then this is divided into two parts over here. Right? This, it is divided into two parts over here. Okay? Then this is EI. This is LI. This is EJ. This is LJ. Right? Okay? Okay. Now this is your head. And this is your tail of the activity, right? So what we will be doing is calculating the tail. This is the tail, okay? 0. Then this is the tail for B and C. So 0, 0. Okay? Then for activity D, 0. Activity E, it will be 18 minus 15. That will be 3. So 0, 3. So 0, 3. And lastly, what we have is this 33 minus 33 will give you a, sorry, this 25 minus 25 is a 0. So all the tails, we get slack of tail by calculating all the values from the tail. That is Li minus Pi. Okay, we move forward to head. Okay, this is head. 6 minus 6 is 0. This is head. 13 minus 13 is 0. This is the tail. This is the head of C. That is 3. This is the head of D and E both. That is 0, 0. And this is the head of F. That is again 0. So this is how we calculate the earliest finish time, the LFT, the latest finishing time, the latest start time, as well as the slack tail and slack of head. Right? We have a project completion time of 33. I hope you have understood. So we will stop for the day. Thank you.